हेलो फ्रेंड्स, स्टूडेंट्स एंड पीपल हु आर इंटरेस्टेड इन रिसर्च आइडियाज, आई एम पुनीत अरोड़ा विद अनदर रिसर्च आइडिया. दिस टाइम द आइडिया इज अगेन सिमिलर टू व्हाट वी डिस्कस्ड इन द लास्ट आइडिया. द आइडिया राइट नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस इज अबाउट डूइंग अ फिजिकल सिमुलेशन ऑफ कार्बोनिफेरस एरा यूजिंग अ जार. आई मीन दिस काइंड ऑफ अ जार. So such kind of jars are basically known as terraniums. So it is basically a physical biological simulation of the period called Carniferous. This period is characterized by a period in which large reptiles and very large scale trees and biomass was there. And due to this era, today we have a biofuel called the coal or the biochar, and it is this is the fossil fuel which we burn to make our electricity and run our cities. In fact, it was this coal was basically as a green mass, as a green biomass. It started in this era, and slowly and gradually it basically got decomposed and got buried inside the different layers of earth. And in the absence of oxygen, the coal was formed. And this era is basically characterized by a large percentage, extraordinary percentage of oxygen in the atmosphere. In those areas, in this time, the earth had 35% oxygen. Today it is about 20 to 21%, between 20 to 21%, and there was a surplus of oxygen. Due to surplus of this oxygen, the plants grew to a very large into a very large biomass. They were thick, they had very huge levels of height. The fish was very large. Most of the fishes were as large as sharks of today. The amphibians came up. The insects were very large in size. They were in fact as large as small cats of today, and there was lot of life thriving on it in that area, that era. To the purpose today is the research idea. The purpose of this research idea is to build a small physical, biophysical environment, biosphere, which will have a similar oxygen level of this era, of the Carniferous era, that is 35%. For making this simulation, we will require a jar, and the jar will be first given extra level of oxygen, that is 35%, similar to what was there in this time. It will have those microbes. This will have some bacteria, fungi, autotrophs, and lot of living microorganisms which are similar to which were still living in those areas, in those era, and they are still existing right now. So we can basically build a small physical physical simulation using such kind of the plants and such kind of environment. There are already people who are making terraniums similar to that, and they are you can have a look at them. They are basically doing a similar kind of thing which I am right now discussing, but none of them are basically doing a longitudinal study, a long-term study, in which they basically study and document, record the changes in the biomass of the plants or the microbes, which is going to due to the high level of oxygen. None of them are basically studying the morphological changes which are going to happen in the microbes or in the plants which are going to be in the terrarium having 35% oxygen, and so on and so forth. So you can use this idea, learn from some YouTube videos which are showing how to make a terrarium of that era, and primarily you will require a large glass, and some people call it terrarium. You will require microscope, you will require Python imaging algorithms or Java imaging algorithms for analyzing the morphology, the shape, size, and the changes in the biomass to deeply understand the exact changes which are occurring due to change in high level of oxygen. And of course you will require somebody who is learned, who knows the taxonomy, he understands what kind of microbes are there, he can identify the microbes, and people who can basically help you to basically do alpha beta kind of biodiversity calculations and so on and so forth. Secondly, I have already discussed the tools you will require. Python, you will require some libraries, some functions for computing the biodiversity. You can even leverage some ready-made models, machine learning models for identifying microbes in case there are already available, or you can even come out using this ideas and the collection of the data from this and develop some machine learning models for identifying the microbes and computing automatic systems for computing the biodiversity. The basic expected outcome of this research work is going to be that you'll be able to understand the environment which was there and compare it with what is happening right now. Again, the oxygen level is getting disturbed. Due to pollution, the carbon dioxide, the number of molecules in the atmosphere are increasing, the percentage is increasing, and you'll be able to do some kind of insightful work and analysis and comparison of what was happening in that era and what is happening right now and what will happen. You will be able to build some model to understand what will happen actually to the sizes, to the biomass, to the size of the biomass, to the weight of the biomass, to the shapes of the biomass and the life when the percentage of molecules of a particular gas changes, especially the oxygen. The sociological impact of this study is going to be that lot of people will get a right kind of an idea and they can witness the history and understand what happened earlier and understand evolution by really observing in a small environment, in a small biosphere. In fact, technologically this study will help you to build models and understand models which will help you to colonize planets such as Mars. Elon Musk is already talking about colonizing Mars, but there, of course, the percentage of oxygen is different. There is a higher percentage of carbon dioxide, which is similar to what is happening right now. The number of molecules, the proportion of molecules of carbon dioxide are increasing in our environment. Some kind of analogy, some kind of comparison, and some kind of inferences can be deduced from this study that how are we going to colonize the different planets which are having different atmosphere, spheric proportions of gases as far as Earth is concerned. I hope you have liked this idea, and in case you have some kind of question about it and you want to know more about it, you can comment and subscribe the channel. Thank you, all the best.